Hi everyone. Finding image of a point, whether it is on a line or it is in a plane, happens to be one of the very important concepts of 3D geometry. Let's explore the same through this video. Let's get started. So looking at the very first question, it says find the image of a point 5, 4, 2 to the given line. The first thing that we usually do is, if you see any line or plane in the vector form, convert it into Cartesian. Trust me, that makes your question very simple. So here your line would become x plus 1 upon 2 is equal to y minus 3 upon 3 is equal to z minus 1 upon minus 1. Now, how did I convert the vector form to the Cartesian? Please check out my video on straight lines in space. You would find the link when you check out my playlist on 3D geometry in the description box. You can also get the same video by clicking at the I button. So once we've done this, now just to understand, now we have to find the image of this point P. By image, it is like you are treating this line as a plane mirror, and at the same distance from this line, you form the image of the point, which I can call as Q, and we have to find the unknown coordinates. You know this point R acts like the middle point of PQ. Also, it is called as foot of the perpendicular. So your question might say that find the image of a point, also find the foot of the perpendicular. Now moving on, when you see this kind of line converted into Cartesian form, equate it with any non-zero constant so that we can get a general point on the line. So here this means my x is 2 alpha minus 1, y is 3 alpha plus 3, and z is minus alpha plus 1. Having written this, these act like the general point which I can represent for R. So my R can have these coordinates. Please note, why did I put this for R? Because alpha can take any value. So that means the moment we find alpha, we will get the exact value for R as well. Now, once we've got the general point, next we find drs of PR. You know you find the drs of a line or a vector by subtracting the initial point from the final point. To check out the details, check the same video, straight lines in space. So here I'll have 2 alpha minus 1 minus 5, that gives us 2 alpha minus 6. Next, 3 alpha plus 3 minus 4, that gives us 3 alpha minus 1. Minus alpha plus 1 minus 2, that gives us minus alpha minus 1. And similarly, the drs of your given line, if I represent the line with L, they are always represented by the denominator, provided you've written the line in the standard form. Or you can also say they are the coordinates of I cap, J cap, K cap if given in the vector form. So here it becomes 2, 3, minus 1. As you can clearly see, this line PR is perpendicular to line L. So now if two lines are perpendicular, we know the dot product of their direction ratios is equal to 0. So we use the same, we say 2 into 2 alpha minus 6 plus 3 into 3 alpha minus 1 minus 1 into minus alpha minus 1, that makes it plus, is equal to 0. Now all we need to do is solve for the value of alpha. So in solving, this is what we get, and thus our alpha is equal to 1. The moment we get alpha is equal to 1, that's it, the problem is sorted, because the moment you substitute the value here, you get the coordinates of R, which would be 1, 6, 0. Please note, this is also known as foot of the perpendicular. So this R point is also known as foot of the perpendicular. And now, since R is the middle point of PQ, suppose I represent these as X1, Y1 and Z1. You know the middle point, which we just calculated as 160. Now you can very conveniently find Q. So, we say since R is the midpoint of PQ, therefore, you know X1 plus 5 by 2 is the same as 1. Similarly, Y1 plus 4 by 2 would be equal to 6, and Z1 plus 2 by 2 should be equal to 0. From here we get X1 to be minus 3, Y1 to be, this is 12 minus 4 which is 8, and Z1 to be simply minus 2. And thus we conclude by saying, therefore, image of the given point P is given by Q, which is minus 3, 8, minus 2. Wasn't the procedure so simple? Now, please have a look at this question. It says, find the image of the point 7, 14, 5 to the plane, which is represented by this. Once again, we convert this plane to the Cartesian form for convenience. You can check out my playlist on vectors and 3D geometry to find the same procedure. So this gets converted to, though it's very simple, you just remove I cap, J cap, K cap and instead put your X, Y and Z. So this becomes 2X plus 4Y minus Z, and this is simply minus 2 is equal to 0. This is the equation of our plane. Now please see, this is the situation that we are given. We once again have to find the coordinates of this Q, which I can again represent as X1, Y1 and Z1. And if I call this as R, that acts like the foot of the perpendicular. Now how do we proceed for such questions? Please note, if I say this is the equation of the plane, now drs of the plane, which are represented by the coefficients of X, Y and Z, are actually the drs of the normal to the plane. Once again, what I'm trying to say is, so direction ratios of a plane are the same as direction ratios of the normal to the plane. So that means this is actually, if I consider the normal to the plane, the drs are 2, 4 and minus 1. So if I represent this with vector n, so we say drs of the plane or drs of vector n are 2, 4 and minus 1. Suppose you consider this plane of board and I say that I have to find the image. You know this point is P and if this is R, so PR is perpendicular to the plane. Also, if I'm talking of normals to the plane, it is going to be somewhere on the plane. But wherever it is, it's going to be parallel to the given line. So, when do we say that the two lines are parallel? When their drs are proportional. So, suppose I represent my point R with alpha, beta, gamma. Then, I can say drs of my line PR are alpha minus 7, beta minus 14 and gamma minus 5. Now, as we can see, this vector n is parallel to my line PR. So, this implies alpha minus 7 by 2 is equal to beta minus 14 by 4 is equal to gamma minus 5 by minus 1. Since when the two lines are parallel, their drs are proportional. So, if I equate it with any non-zero constant, say t, this gives me my alpha is 2t plus 7, my beta is 4t plus 14 and my gamma is minus t plus 5. Please note all these symbols, alpha, beta, gamma, t or x1, y1, z1 is something which I am choosing on my own. You are free to do the same. Now, once I have the points alpha, beta and gamma, as you can clearly see, this point R also lies on the plane. What does that mean? That simply means that my point R is going to satisfy the equation of the plane. So we say since R lies on the plane, therefore I am substituting the values for alpha, beta and gamma in the given equation. So we get twice of 2t plus 7 plus 4 times 4t plus 14 minus t plus 5 minus 2 is equal to 0. Let's solve for the value of t once again. So on simplifying, we get 21t plus 63 is 0, which means t is equal to minus 3. You know, when you substitute for t, you get alpha, beta, gamma, which is the foot of the perpendicular, and then you can use your midpoint formula to get the image. So this means my alpha, so this means my coordinates for R become, if I substitute my t here, it is 2 into minus 3 plus 7. That gives me my alpha as 1. Next, beta is 4 into minus 3 plus 14, which gives us 2. Next, my gamma is minus of minus 3 plus 5. That gives us 8. So, foot of the perpendicular for the given point becomes the point 1, 2, 8. Let's now use the midpoint formula. You would say, therefore, x1 plus 7 by 2 is equal to 1. y1 plus 14 by 2 is equal to 2. And z1 plus 5 by 2 is equal to 8. On simplifying, you get x1 to be minus 5, y1 to be minus 10 and z1 to be 11. Therefore, the point Q, which is also the image of the given point P, happens to be minus 5, minus 10, 11. Please go through the entire thing once again. I hope you all enjoyed learning about image of a point to a line and to a plane. Please practice the concept, as it is very important from your examination point of view as well. If you like the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with the friends around you, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel. It's free. See you with the next video. Until then, bye-bye.